Hello, I'm Mr. Anager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, and I want to over here tell you that the religious knowledge is in the Middle East and in the East. In the West, there is no religious knowledge, but they appreciate the religious knowledge which is in these two countries, which is Israel and India. And that's why Jesus said, lightning strike in the east, in India, and flashes towards the west. That means it's not appreciated in east, but in the west people appreciate it. So what the prophet and Christ, you know, which is a very son of God. Prophets are reflection of the written Torah, oral Torah. Let me show you the picture. That will clarify the concept of prophet. John the Baptist was a witness to the light and not the light, and he was the last prophet. And here you have the Christ, the very source of light, Son. And here are Christ and Saint. Saint are also sons of the Most High. Mary Magdalene, she was a saint, and she was the son of the Most High, son of Elohim, Allah, Pabram. And here are the prophets. The prophets were all men, because this is the word of Adam. And to the Adam, you know, the lesson is given. So in synagogue, that's why to the men, the lessons are given, not to the women. So those who are perfect in the moral law, they are called prophet or angel. So John the Baptist was a prophet or angel. So was Stephen, the first martyr. He was in here. He was baptized with Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, which the temple priest did not like, because they were making them Jew outwardly, of appearance, not of heart. So prophets, when they appeared in the Middle East among the Jewish people, they hated them, they killed them. But when the prophets were appreciated by other people, people from other countries, when they read about them and they appreciated it, then to fleece people, they built churches and other things, you know, tombs and all that thing, so that people can come and we can fleece money. The dark age, you know, mammon and media is of Satan. And that is why these American Jews, which is mammon and media, they are creating hell all over the world, killing people and all that. So here is the cartoon made by a deputy head of the Green Party. A Jewish man putting on the American flag, having sickle, having David's cross, and that is bringing bloodshed from one country after the other. So they were the greatest blasphemer, and they are to be punished. And that's why Putin is going to punish them. Because now, according to Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, the tares, the sons of Satan, are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. and that would be in 14 May 2023 when Israel is 75 years old. So that's why this atomic wars signs are appearing now. Remember what Putin is going to do is the third war of judgment. There have been two world wars. And this is the third war. This is going to be of judgment. So, in judgment, the sons of man, they will win. While the sons of Satan, they will lose. So, sons of man are those who are faithful to their tribal fathers. So, in Russia, the people in the state, they have tribal identity, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, and so. So these tribal people, they are entitled to live on this planet Earth and nobody else. The Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew, etc., they were all perish. Khatri, Protestant, Labour Party, this and that, they were all kill each other. That's why 144,000 that would be saved, they're all mentioned by their tribes and not as Jews. So, in India, the second coming of Jesus took place. Over there, the Satan was of high quality, very powerful. So over there, Nanak, he preached gospel. And these Satan of Khatri tribe in Middle East was Juda tribe, in East which was Khatri tribe, they were his staunch enemy. Least of them became Sikh, 0.7%. And our people, my tribal people, they 70%. They adopted Sikhism, and they were the greatest among all. Then other village people, they adopted Sikhism. But the town people, mostly they remained orthodox, or what they were doing before. Like in the Israel, they were Jew. They remained Jew. They did not become sons of Abraham. Abraham was not a Jew. He was a Semitic race. So, in India, they were staunch enemy of Sikhism. And when they died, then they make their Sikh temple and all that, you know, the places where they visited. And they make temples over there, Sikh temples. And again, they fleece people for money. There is no teaching over there. Nanak, he was a Satguru. Satguru means the one who preaches gospel, Sat. He was not a Brahman Guru. Brahman Guru, who is the moral teacher. So the Sikhs are twice born people, not the once born people. Once more people, they become fanatic. They like sugar-coated sermons. And if they are not given sugar-coated sermon, well, they can kill you. Very powerful fanatic in India. So the Indian sons of Satan, people of Khatri tribe, they were so clever that they keep on changing the version, you know. One person will praise, the other person will praise. And also this holy book, which they are reading in the church, in the Gurdwaras, or their churches, is highly corrupted. So this is highly forbidden by Christ Arjun. But people are reading it and all that thing they do. So in this dark age, people who were very clever, they hated them most because this is the age of opportunists. So to have the opportunity or the favor of the king and other people, secular authority, they had no fear because they were supported by them. So in India, you know, the people of Khatri tribe, they did all their efforts to against Sikhism and against Khalsaism. Khalsa is the third path, it's different from Sikhism. So what Sikh do? Serve without any distinction. That means they observe agape love. So in the Sikhism, they are the Stanic people. They adopted the other Mohammedan type of religious facts. And after joining them, because the ruling party was Mohammedan, and then they tried to put the light under bushel. Remember that the light is to be put on the top of the table or lampstand, which as I have done it here, this is the light written on my hoodie, and I display it. So in India, they were too clever to be apprehended. Now, in Sikhism, there are six light, six houses, and six lights for different house. Sheikh or Sheikh of Desh. So, then we had six Satgurus and four Satchepasha, royal king. Up to the Arjun, he was the fifth one. Then the last Satguru was Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji, the sixth light in Sikhism. But when he went to Amritsar to pay homage to his house, they locked the door. They won't let him in. So he sat outside, and then he say, you know, Amritsariye, Amritsariye, meaning that people of Amritsar, they are greediest of all people. So over there they are producing books and literature, which is all falsehood, which you can only understand if you have Christ in your heart. Christ is called Satguru. So when you have Satguru in your heart, then you can understand Satguru Nanak and Satguru Angad Dev Ji and every Satguru. And also appreciates Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji. Sache Pasha, he was not a Guru Gobind Singh or something like that. To call him a guru, it to degrade him. So, in India, they start burning them, and all they did. But now, when the people, especially village people, Jatt, they appreciate what they did. And now they want to take that credit from them. So there are a lot of things which are happening now, just the opposite. And I've got this video now going to close down. So you should ponder over your heart yourself. Remember that at the time of Satguru Nanak Dev Ji, which was a fifth light, Satguru Arjan Dev Ji, these Khatris were creating their own bani, which was quite lucrative. And the Sikhs asked Satguru Arjan Dev Ji to write the true version. So he written the true version. But these Khatri, they don't like it. So they killed him. So this is the end of the age. And as the lightning strikes in the east, flashes for the west, so shall be the coming Son of Man. And that was Nanak in India. And they maltreated them, the whole family. So that's, I think, I would say now. And I put lots of videos which you can enjoy. Oh dear.